हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स रिलेटेड टू स्पोर्ट्स विच विल बी आस्क्ड इन यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स 2023। सो द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज इंडियाज फुटबॉल विजन 2047। सो द ऑल इंडिया फुटबॉल फेडरेशन अनवेल्ड अ स्ट्रेटेजिक रोड मैप विथ विजन 2047, होपिंग दैट In the country's century year of independence, India will emerge as a new powerhouse of Asian football, developed by conjunction with all the stakeholders within the football, Indian football, and a roadmap has also sorted and incorporated input from the Asian Football Confederation and FIFA Football Association. AIFF has broken down Vision 2047 into 6 4-year strategic plan. The first of these will look cover the period till 2026. Indian football's visions 2047. National football philosophy. The national football philosophy of India would be based on collecting data from scouting, creating a technical curriculum, focusing on coach and player development, and hoping it would translate into the talent pool for the national team. To create a national playing philosophy, the AIFF will develop the coach of education program to improve the quality of football at all level of ecosystem. The AIFF has also targeted to creating 50,000 active coaches amongst 4,500 of minimum AIFFC license across the country. The focus will collecting the data to creating the scouting system will be charged off, will do so by 2026. With the overall approach to finding the football philosophy through the remains the same. Vibrant footballing ecosystem. A roadmap of envisions India to be amongst the top four footballing nations in Asia, host one of the top leagues in Asia, and create a vibrant football ecosystem. Village Grassroots Program. AIFF aims to implement village grassroots programs to reach 35 million children across 100 villages throughout the India, and also aims to register 1 million registered players to provide football education to 25 million of children through the football or for schools. They noted that there are a huge gender disparity in participation at grassroots level. Enhancements of women participation. A four-level league table pyramid will be created for women football by 2026, with the top of the pyramids to be occupied by Indian Women League, followed by the second divisions. AIFF has also targeted the minimum of 20 states to implement the new women youth structure by 2027. A women football ecosystem has been weak in the country and needed a specific solution to help to increase participation and competency, also mentioning the need to improve the minimum salary infrastructure. The AIFF will improve infrastructure by putting the place of policy intervention that will incentivize government authorities, football clubs, corporates, or private investor to invest infrastructure. Scenario of football in India. About the football in India is currently a developing stage despite being the second most populous country in the world. Football is not popular in India as cricket. Challenges. One of the main challenges facing football in India is lack of investment and infrastructure. Many stadiums and training facilities are the poor conditions. They are the shortage of properly trained coaches and trainers. This makes it difficult for players to develop their skills for teams to complete high level potential. The Indian national team has made the strides and improved the FIFA ranking and the ISL I League have been seen to increase the popularity of attendance, and there have been some successful Indian players in overseas league. Overall, football in India still have a long to go, but there are some positive development and there is potential to growth in the future. The recent efforts of AIFF to improve the grassroots level football training and development, coaches, referees, infrastructure and promoting the game of our newer areas and schools will help to bringing more to the game and increase the popularity and success. The AIFF is an organization that manages the game association football in India. It administrator in the running of India's national football team and also control I League, India's premier domestic club competition, in addition to the various other competitions and teams. The AIFF was founded in 1937 and gained FIFA affiliation in the year 1948 after India's independence in 1947. Currently, it is the office of Dwarka, New Delhi. India was one of the founding members of Asian Football Confederation in 1954. Now, next topic is Commonwealth Games. So, the 21st edition of Commonwealth Games kicks off the opening ceremony in host city Buckingham, United Kingdom. India is leading the way of a strong contingent. Given India's economy and the country's young demographics, the narrative of sports in India is undergoing the transformation. But sports becoming the interest in India's has not necessarily translated into the better performance in overall sports sectors. Barring a few sports like cricket and shootings, there are the high level of complexity in the Indian sports sectors and diverse organizations, governing bodies, private companies, non-for-profit foundation, etc. are responsible for delivering the managing sports in India. Ultimately, the size and complexity of the sector is the significant contributor to a series of specific governance and challenges for sports in India. Now, about Commonwealth Games. The Commonwealth Games Federation, which oversees the games to chooses a host cities, manages the sporting program. International Sports Federation, Commonwealth Game Association and organizing bodies for each individual Commonwealth game make up the movement of game. A few customs that are specific to the games, including rising the Commonwealth Games flag, the Queen Baton Rally, and the opening and closing ceremonies. Typically, gold, silver, and bronze medal are given to winners of the first, second, and third places in the event. Despite the Commonwealth nation has 56 members, there are 72 Commonwealth Games Association. So you must be remember this fact. Each of its six regions, Africa, the Americas, the Caribbean, Europe, Asia, and Oceania, performers are comparable role to that the National Olympic Committee in relation to their respective nation or territories. The CGA duties are carried out by the NOC in other countries such as South Africa and India. One of the ways that the Commonwealth Games differ from other मल्टी स्पोर्ट्स कॉम्पिटिशंस इज दैट द 15 CGA टेकिंग अपार्ट डू नॉट सेंड डेलीगेशन सेपरेटली फ्रॉम द ओलंपिक पैरा ओलंपिक एंड अदर मल्टी स्पोर्ट्स इवेंट्स. दिस इज बिकॉज 13 ऑफ द CGA आर affiliated with the British Olympic Association, which is affiliated with the Australian Olympic Committee, and the another affiliated with the New Zealand Olympic Committee, just like their Paralympic counterparts. Issues associated with sports governance in India. Unclear demarcation of rights and responsibility. Sports is delivered many different parties. Currently, there are very little distinction between the management and governance with the Indian sports. In many Indian sporting organizations, the executive committee, a body ostensibly responsible for governance, usually find itself doing the management work. Lack of check and balances. In the pretext of autonomy, they have been allowed to function in any manner without checks and balances. Lack of transparency and accountability. The current avant sports model faces accountability issues, such as that the having unlimited discretionary power, and also there is not transparency of decision making with regularity in revenue management. For instance, in July 2010, the Central Vigilance Commission released the report to show that there were irregularities of 14 projects of Commonwealth Games held in India. In 2013, India's Premier League sports fixings and betting case arose. Delhi police arrested the three cricketers on the charge of alleged sport fixing. Subsequently, the Lodha Committee is appointed by the Supreme Court of India to analyze and recommend their implementable actions and improving the Board of Control Cricket of India, BCCI. Inaugurate professionalization. Many Indian sports organizations, particularly the governing bodies, have not made structural adaptations to meet the associated challenges of commercialized and professional sectors. These organizations continue to the relay of volunteers to manage the operation of organization rather than hiring skilled professionals to handle the increased workload. Sports as a hobby and professions. In India, sports is primarily viewed as a hobby due to its low success rate, academic pressure and job seeker mentality, making it a difficult for the youth pursue sports art as a profession. Lack of sufficient infrastructure. Status of sports infrastructure in India is yet to reach at a desired level. This creates obstacles to the developing a culture and sports in the country. According to the Constitution of India, sports is a state subject. Consequently, there are no comprehensive approach for the development of sports infrastructure uniformly throughout the country. Performance enhancing drugs. Use of enhancing drugs are still a major problem to the sectors. This problem needs to be addressed efficiently despite the creation of National Anti-Doping Agency in the country. Way forward. Adequate infrastructure investment to become a lending nation. India to have invest heavily in a building and modern infrastructure with national best practices of sports training, sport medicines, research and analysis across the sports institution with the adequate attention to all major sports. The quality of infrastructure can be scaled up to the village level, and regional centers should be made available for those who are serious to taking their sports professionally. Effect legislative backing. In the absence of a strong legislation, there will be no efficiency in the function of the sport authorities. Also, there might be the absolute political intervention which will be easily checked out a well-drafted legislation, reducing anomalies, restructuring governance and management. There should be a proper demarcating the role and responsibility among the different bodies involved in the Indian sports sector to minimize the use of resource and ensure there is no gap of meeting of needs to of sports. However, these needs is done for conjunctions with the sector to state and cannot be directorate along with the inclusion of professional and strategic and management sports. Formation of separate functions group management and sponsorships, media right and government funding will fix the responsibility of revenue management. Thomas Cup. Thomas Cup, related to Thomas Cup trophy, signifies the world supremacy of sports badminton. It is a 16-nation team event, background and managed by. The cup is donated in 1939 by Sir George Thomas for a series of men's international team competitions to be managed by the International Badminton Federation, of which Thomas and then present. First tournament. The first tournament was also held in 1948-49 and won by Malaya. The Thomas Cup Uber Cup is the biennial in international badminton championships contested by the men and the women's national team. India's win. In the tournament's 7-decade-long history, the championships little has a changed hands only among the 5 nations: China, Malaysia, Indonesia, Japan and Denmark. With its win, India became the only 6th country ever break into this elite club. If you want to download this PDF, please check in the description links. And thanks for watching, friends, and don't forget to subscribe, share, like and comment.